100%.
Well, let's see what it's gonna be. Training catch, apparently. We've just been told by the voice in our heads.
Okay.
Bravado here. That's gonna be on the T sides and set of nades and a deagle.
Wow.
With a headshot straight from the get go.
The very confident deagle buy on the pistol round. Always good to see. There are only a couple of players, not even a handful, that I feel like are good enough to pull that off.
It's like simple.
Simple. Yeah. Nico.
Yeah. Nico. Simple.
Kirby.
Kirby, yeah. Okay. Definitely. With his really weird aiming style.
Yeah. As like hackery aimers.
Yeah.
I got to be careful with that. People are,
yeah. Don't want to be on front page of Reddit with that.
Not at all. No. Very
slow
good player.
Start, though, this round. Apart from that, Black Poison getting that headshot. South Africans just taking it easy. Still have two Molotovs to play with, so they've used their smokes outside. Seems like it's going to be a yard split coming in.
Yep, they're going to be moving out into the site. Bomb leading, and a couple of smokes. Not a third one on the top of the middle of the site, but it won't be a big problem as the kills have already met them halfway. Mr. Six realizes he's got to make a play in the situation. Pushes through the smoke, gets taken down by Gulls. And it's all just onward. Wargeely and the... Whoa, the aggressive knife jumping out at him. We got the deagle entry on the pistol round, the jumping through the smoke knife.
That's a fiery start.
I think that's bravado. That's what bravado is.
No, but nice approach there from Bravado for sure. I mean, you know, they're taking things slowly apart from that deagle headshot, obviously. Then setting up those smokes on left and right side of the bomb train, molotoving a thing with the Z connector, and just trying to force that bomb plan. But once you get all those entry kills, it makes it all that easier. Ending up in a massive numbers advantage for them going into that bomb site.
Now, I wonder how Bravado feel. They're playing again a team that's basically maybe the third best team in China, but relatively unknown. And then there was a whole period of dominance from the Brazilians where it was like, okay, every Brazilian team's going to be insane, and they just started picking them up left, right, and center. But at a certain point, the talent does fall off, and not everybody is quite that good.
Yeah.
So I wonder how much respect Bravado have for them.
I mean, what you want to do is try to have rather, like, don't get too aggressive to start things off. Kind of feel the game a little bit to start things off, see how they play, and that kind of jazz. So I think something we might be seeing here. Seems like a bit of an investment coming in from the Chinese side. They have a scout in play, some armors, upgraded pistols, and
not everybody spent all their money, but they're doing quite a bit of damage. Two players are low. They're going to be called out that it's scouts that hit them, and so they know the pistols are going to be quite effective right now. Back bomb are both of the players left on 5 club, but the cleanup seems to be coming up from Bravado. Actually, quite a winnable round all of a sudden as Dysaber gets that initial kill with the CZ. Moving up into the heaven position, has going to have a lot of line of sight. Actually spots the head of somebody through the glass and will kill him with just that one bullet. Ends up being a headshot as well, but Sonic there to trade.
Yep. As an idea, it's good to keep the distance when you're planning against a half force buy. Since they have so many AKs on the play by Bravado, obviously that scout is going to be the one factor that might change things up there. It did get a little close for comfort, but end of the day, Bravado is still prevailing in that round. 5 sports club need to take a save here. Some occurred a pistol, so that means they're going to have a bit of a tougher time going into the first weapon round.
Mm. I like the aggressiveness right now, actually, just speeding things up versus the saving players, making sure they don't get into any tricky positions. And a couple of players are just stacked up behind them with a teammate shooting them as well. So everybody's positions have been compromised, and at least that saver last man alone.
That's what I call showing dominance.
Showing dominance, yes. Letting them know.
Just we're tap. Coming for you.
Yes.
Rushing
your
guard.
Time is limited.
Let's see what if they keep those MacDaddies.
MacDaddies.
Elusive and Detroni. I'm too blind for this.
Yeah, so they might let me move this up for you. So they might, it looks like they, no, they aren't going to keep one. I was thinking, you know, maybe they're going to call out the fact that a couple of players don't have head armor.
I mean, you can either do like a really fast alley push, or you can do an inner push straight away using those SMGs. But other than that, it might be a little hard.
These guys have absolutely no chill. Another execute right out the gate. Detroni just catching Wargeely, spamming, and MH biceps actually joins in the fun. But now it is suddenly a man advantage for Bravado. Once again, familiar territory for them. And Dreyer and Dysaber are trying to move into the site, make a play. Dysaber has been pretty consistent, but now is just by himself. Technically a one-on-four situation that is still far from winnable, but all of a sudden, the tides have turned.
I definitely have. Still, the bomb plan's going to go down. It's going to be tough in a one-on-two in this map, unless he gets two individual one-on-ones, which seems to be the case almost. It's going to be elusive in the end that takes it out. And with that round for Bravado, but I like that early aggression though. I mean, what that is going to do for the CTs now, in their heads, they're going to think we need to use a lot of grenades in the early part of the round initially to make sure if they do rush, you know, we're going to make it uncomfortable for the T's to come out. But at the same time now, if Bravado does slow things down, that's going to be a lot of nades. The five's already been spent for nothing, basically. So psychologically, that's a big round to win.
Yeah, and once again, I mean, just the terror that must be associated with these smokes for 5 Club, as they know they've lost so many rounds to these. Seeing them cascade over the site hasn't actually baited out a reaction. I think that's all it's going to tell Bravado, is that they just don't have enough money to counter nade at this point. They've earned themselves a save, which is a nice bit of comfort, mental comfort. Bomb's obviously on the floor, meaning that they don't have any plans to go anywhere quite yet. And haven't been offered up a kill. Elusive taking down Mr. Six with a clean headshot. I was told to watch out for Mr. Six.
Okay.
PTW.
I love his nicknames, by the way. Mr.
Yeah.
Six.
And on Five Sports Club, Mr. Six.
Beautiful. Rhymes beautifully.
Yeah, exactly.
Bravado just taking things slowly. Just a default round, basically holding off, making sure if the CTs play aggressively, they're going to be ready for it. And they have been, as you pointed out. It's going to be the first kill going their way. And now they seem to be gathering up towards the end of the bomb site and just waiting for that right time to make an execute.
Now, obviously, Inner, from our perspective, is clearly the better site to go to. And Bravado has spent a lot of time going to A. Is there anything that would make you want to go B, just because maybe you haven't gone there before?
I mean, this is the point in time you kind of, I mean, this inner bomb site for me against an eco always feels a little risky. So many angles that might be your massive trouble, basically. So usually what I want to like to do in these situations is that you smoke in or you flash in, or maybe you send one there to make some noise and then you go on a ladder, go out or bomb site,
right?
Because it's just more wide open, basically, and you'll have longer distances 100%.
Also, it's a lot easier to cause rotations towards inner, because typically people only play one there anyway.
Yeah.
So it's gonna be hard to pull that guy no matter how much stuff you throw outside sometimes.
Yeah.
Depending on the team you're seeing. But the quick 5-0 start. Really nice.
CT play. First time.
Yeah, first time they've got Molotovs. And this smoke again, and I mean, this kind of acts as like they're actually throwing a couple. So, but $600 and two smokes out of the round they can't use anymore, which is a semi-big investment. But the counter mollies haven't really come out, so they've hung on to these. I think they've called out the fact that they don't need to maybe get too antsy quite yet. But a really nice pick from Black Poison. Opportunistic moment.
Yeah, he's done great so far. I mean, so many impact kills. First kills of the round so far. And it's going to be the second one going away to Bravado as well. And that's going to be an open inner bomb site. Obviously, they don't know it, but they're still going to run with it.
Mm.
And they're going to find it empty.
It's crazy how much confidence we're seeing come out of this team. Honestly, have expected them to be a really good matchup. That is Five Sports Club to be a really good matchup for Bravado. But it seems like Bravado are just treating them as if they're just not in their league right now.
Yeah, very impressive so far for sure. I think Black Poison actually spent quite a bit of time in, I want to say, Sweden. So he's been pugging, playing with Nordic players a lot. So I'm sure he's like gotten a lot of ideas on how the game is supposed to be played, how the meta
is. Come back with all the stories.
Exactly.
Like, listen, guys, gather around. I'm going to tell you how the
daddy's going to tell you how it's going to be done.
No one can, he can lie about stuff. They would never be able to call him out.
Exactly.
He's going to make a bad play. Like,
but
I
so
think
far,
that's a bad play. He's like, no, listen, JW taught me that play.
Yeah, so far, I mean, it's looked great. And Black Poison's been a massive part of them winning these rounds, because he's been the one to initiate. Like, they've been doing these defaults fast pushes, but also the default there, the previous round, he was the one to initiate, just walking towards pushing alley. Mm-hmm. He saw a CT that peaked, he got the kill, and that kind of made the domino effect of everyone's ramming.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, that's the little things you need to have a player to do those dirty jobs in the game for things to work.
So that's like something I noticed, is like a team that is up and coming or not very good in general, they scatter. They lose that first kill, and then they lose their brains. They have like no comfort at all. They just start, everybody starts making plays.
I think the issue for a lot of emerging teams is like individuals not able to react on the fly well enough or fast enough, basically. So what you need to have is a lot of structure into basically protocols on when certain things happen, how do we react? So that's something you need to have when you don't necessarily have the routine to be able to adapt and react to things accordingly. So would be interesting to know if they've actually built some of these protocols to, if we get a pick on Alley, you know, this is what we do. Or
right.
if we get a pick on Ladder, this is what we do, so forth. So, you know, that's kind of a shortcut for yourself to be able to make your team play better.
Yeah, and it certainly seems like Bravado, at least from their perspective, they definitely have that, and it's more, you know, do Five Sports Club have that, or are they just succumbing to the pressure of constantly having to figure out how to come back from that kill? And that first kill is so strong, right?
Yeah, and so far, I mean, they've been picked from different parts of the map, so it kind of makes it hard on how do we adapt, because we've been picked from Team Middle, from Ladder, from Alley, so basically like the three key points of the
yeah.
map, right? So, like, what's the deal here? How do we approach? Basically, you know, you either on CT side, you play either really up front on Yard, heavy emphasis towards Team Middle or Ladder, or are you going to be playing like two towards Alley?
Right, don't let yourself get smoked out completely,
yeah.
right, if you're going to at least try to trade. Like,
yeah.
FNX is a really good player for that, always up at E-Box, the side of the train, and just,
yeah.
You know, if somebody, you want to throw all these smokes outside, okay, but I'm going to tell my team exactly what's going on, because I'm right here.
And Kerrigan, actually, when he was playing in Strollers, he was really good at playing six train.
Definitely. Oh, again, these smokes every single round. Five Club have to decide how they want to react to it. Initial nade goes out, and Black Poison once again leading the charge, looking for an op flick, doesn't find it, and maybe won't. And all that did was pull instantly the rotate all the way to Z. Their one man there, Die Saber, who's been so good on the rotation to Outer. Now feels like, damn, I wish I just stayed in the site so I could have shown them what I was made of.
It's psychological warfare at this point right. in time. I mean, you don't make a move before you see that bomb in radar.
Mm-hmm.
That's literally, you don't leave a bomb site open until you know the bomb 100% is going to come to your bomb site.
Sage advice, right? Absolutely. I think he maybe felt like, you know, my teammates just getting blasted outside every time I'm rotating. I'm like, I'm too late, but I swear
yeah.
I'm going fast. So this time he's like, I'm beating him to the punch. I'm going right now.
Yeah, oh, great. Again, very impressed with Bravado so far.
Yeah, and as you mentioned, I mean, Black Poison just looks really, really confident. Always out there in front, even when he's not getting the kill. He's done it with so many different weapons. I mean, he's picked
yeah.
up the op. But
yeah,
he's also
started
got
off the Deagle.
AK up at Alley, the Deagle and the Pistol Red.
Yeah, the versatile player if you've ever seen one.
Take it till you make it, I guess.
See what Five Sports Club decide to do here. It seems like they're going to be forcing into feeling the pressure at this point in time. It's going to be 7-0 for Bravado already.
This is the train trap, though. I mean, you lose so many rounds and you're like, well, we need a CT side. But at the same time, you really need money to win rounds
yeah.
on CT side. That's a big problem.
Yeah.
That Fama's fall-off damage is really from back lanes to TCon.
That's one thing I want to get fixed in this game. FAMAS needs to become viable again, please. Mm. I'll rather buy a UMP than a FAMAS, if I'm honest.
Yeah, that's for sure. Oh, there's a couple of kills. Black Poison shut down immediately. One more kill is had, where Jilly is actually doing work right now. Very good stuff. Suddenly, Bravado are in the face of a clutch situation. Our man, Sonic, will be the man of the hour. I don't know what his rotate is. It looks like he's going to try to make his way up Ivy.
Yeah, well, I would say now his mission is to make at least one more kill. Mm. So that means that they're not going to be able to drop weapons fully for everyone.
Right, kill majority.
Yep.
Yeah, kill majority, and they honestly don't even have to worry about this whole reset or actually winning the round. This economic damage, such a big problem for Five Slug Sports right now. And that's smoke. Oh my gosh.
Close, but no cigar.
Will the kill happen? No, not quite yet. Oh, and he doesn't get it. They get they do come in with the three kills. They still lost two. It still will matter.
Yeah.
They're not going to have a super great buy, and they didn't even consider an op. He had 6K for one moment, but pretty much hit that auto buy as soon as the round changed. Ops critical untrained, not necessarily necessary.
I mean, it depends kind of opera you have, right?
Yeah,
if you have a really good opera,
it
can definitely be helpful for sure. But you can definitely still win rounds CT side without it if you just have a good system going for you. And again, seems like Bravado applying pressure on Alley. It's going to be the first kill going their way once again over there. It's a great start.
Yeah, that seemed like a little bit of an indecisiveness because he pushed up really fast, but then
yeah.
he hit for a second, and then he peaked. It's,
yeah.
you know, he could have got a lot farther if he didn't half foot in, half foot out.
Counter-Strike ABCs, don't do that.
Right. Be deliberate, be decisive.
Yep.
And you re-decide to make a play, just do something else. Do something else.
Exactly. Well, now they've lost control of Alley, and as we can see right now from the minimap, CTs look very uncomfortable. They have no control of any part of the map, and that's going to be Bravado just flooding in. From Alley.
Mm. And this is the value of taking IV control, right? You can make the outside guys uncomfortable by compromising all these positions where they have to check their back all of a sudden when before they just had to look two ways.
The bomb's gone this way toward the inner bomb side. It now is a 2-on-1 with Mr. Six from Five Sports Club being the last man standing.
Yeah, we've heard a lot about, well, there have been rumors about this man. We'll see if the legend comes true.
Yeah?
I don't know.
What kind of legends?
I can't talk about those.
Fair enough.
You're going to have to buy the book. Yeah, I mean, he just doesn't have enough time to win it, unfortunately.
No, the dream is dead.
Maybe he's just decided not to win this round. He doesn't want to show us the secrets quite yet. But this is a bad round to lose. This is a reset right here. He's going to take this M4, probably join his teammates, who are most likely going to have $500 pistols. And, a couple of people actually do have a buy-up, and
yeah,
you know, because he has an M4 already, that's going to definitely encourage it. UMP's great weapons, but once again, a relatively low buy, and
I mean, that previous round basically died in the guy who pushed Ali not being decisive about it and lost the duel against those two guys, and then you know, pressure being applied from Ali, and then you could see from the minimap how uncomfortable CTs were, just out of position everywhere basically, and then just getting penciled and straightforward stuff.
It's really important to remember on CT side, like, staying alive is way more important than going one for one.
Yeah.
Pretty much every single time. Oh, this Molly. A good reaction actually pushes him out. Elusive goes down. That's a kill for free. No damage done whatsoever. And no trade in sight. Looks like Dice Saber's done a pretty good job inner.
That's perfect as it gets, really, for him. Now, I'm not really sure what he's doing here. Playing with the smoke. A bit of a danger. But then again, a lot of information right now being gained by Dreer.
How would you want to say Dreamer, right? Because of
right, yeah, it might be Dreamer actually.
No, I mean, because Dreamer spells it the exact same way.
Right. Okay.
But yeah, definitely.
Who knows?
Definitely don't have the M in there either way.
Well,
one of these days, these guys are gonna be legends, and we're gonna, you know, they're gonna pull up this clip of how someone can pronounce his name.
Fair enough. It's been equalized here.
Yeah, he goes down, and he had such a favorable spot. And it actually, you know, typically you don't want to push in a 5v4 because you're winning. But at the same time, it doesn't mean you win just because you have 5v4. And he pushed TCOM because they had spotted that inner presence, right?
Yep.
It was clear it was going to be an inner take. So it was a good push, but it didn't pay off. And now they're in a really, really tight spot once again. Definitely going to have to save if they lose this one. And Bravado still have four players up.
Coming in.
There it is. Three people crossing outside. One in hell right now where Jilly gets a kill with a nade. And Detroni Black Poison join in to get a couple, but it leaves just one man in a 1v2. That's our man Detroni again. Goes up to the higher ground, but puts himself in view of two players. Gets killed with just a few seconds remaining, and Five Sports Club win that by the skin of their teeth.
Well, I was going to say Bravado should buy because they know that money is not great for Five Sports Club right now.
Mm-hmm.
And they are doing that exactly. Not the greatest buy, but still. It's viable for them. And they know it's a gamble there they should take because they can win million rounds out of it.
So if you're Five Sports Clubs, you're anticipating what here? You're hoping they don't buy?
Yeah. But then you're thinking they know we're low on money, so...
Exactly.
They will probably buy. But then again, you know, they're not going to have the greatest weaponry, so maybe you take a passive approach to how you hold. As we can see right now from the minimap, they are very invested towards Ali because we've seen Bravado put two men there a lot of the time. But instead, it's going to be Bravado setting up for those smokes on yard.
Oh, we've got a fast flank inner, though. He's already pushing up, and our two-minute ladder might get instantly killed. Depending on what this looks like, Dreer, there he is, getting a couple of frags. Those aren't even the players that I thought that he was going to kill. And he's actually going to fall off this position really good to get new ground. Still cause fear to his teammates or in the opposing team. And Sonic is all alone all of a sudden. So a couple of really good pushes. Dreer actually didn't get away with it last round, but this round pays off.
Ooh. A little jumpy there. Taking his teammate.
It was a nice shot, though. That's what matters.
Sonic alone in a 105. Gets a kill. It's a good start, but that's all she wrote. And that flank definitely was the key factor. Set up from Bravado there for auto push. Basically just trying to isolate that bomb site from everything else on yard and force the bomb plant and an after plant situation and a, you know, 5-on-5, 4-on-4 situation, and then just trying to get the good positioning basically afterwards to hold off the CTs.
I know, but Bravado called attack, so what's the motive? What's the MO right now?
I mean, they've lost a couple in a row right now, right? So they just want to, I guess, take a bit of a breather, just talk things through. What's been working for us? Why did we lose these rounds? And for the better part, it's just basically trying to break down that little momentum that Five's been able to get here for with a couple of rounds they were on. So nothing too drastic in my opinion. I think they're in a very, very good position right now, but they've definitely seemed the more dominant of the two here in the first half.
Five at the very least, if there's anything to say, they've done a good job of keeping the money low for Bravado so they didn't have to work too hard to get them to a save. Even on that last round where it was kind of like, oh, we smell blood, they still were extremely low, and so didn't have a great chance of winning it, but it was definitely worth the risk.
That's interesting to see if Bravado is going to go down back to the two alley setup default they had previously working for them and getting a lot of picks out of that. And if Five is actually going to do something about it, if they're going to invest more towards alley, have some going to play like a pop flash going in there and just trying to brute force themselves towards alley and try to neutralize that area of the map.
Two people enter that smoke. Meant to do a little bit of damage, help with that entry, or just stagger some opponents who weren't actually there. But still, a good bit of information again has been gathered. And this is going to be a straight up eco round. Mr. Six falling back to safety. And with these 20 M4 bullets, able to get a couple of kills with the help of Die Saber. Bomb now is spotted, and they're all just coming out one at a time through ladder.
What happened with. I mean, you'd think if they want to come down the ladder, they would smoke both sides of the bomb train. You know, try to actually get that bomb plant.
Yeah.
If you leave one of them open, one side open, then there's going to be a free lane for the AKs and M4 just wreck you down.
Either just like CT or like all the way from Ivy. All of these people can see you. Yeah.
Yeah. So,
300 bucks.
Not really sure what went through their heads there.
No, yeah. And ladder is a really good eco strat because TCON, it's like you got to cross three lanes to get to the bomb site, but you go down ladder, you just run up the side of the wall.
I like to go in a bomb site because a lot of CTs play quite rather passively, especially if they know that you're playing against an eco just in case, you know?
Yeah, some teams will let you plant. Yeah, it's super easy to retake.
Yeah. Well, it's going to be the first pick here coming from Dreer with an AWP there at a bomb site, taking a peek from high ramp. Which I wanted for them.
Our inner player is taking a lot of initiative right now. It seemed like Die Saber was doing good on the clutches when he had to rotate in, and Dreer has been doing good on the aggressive pushes.
I think the right strategy right now for Five is to neutralize back poison early in the rounds. It feels like those are the rounds where they've been winning.
Yeah, and he's still not afraid of getting in their faces, but losing these duels. And Mr. Six doesn't seem fully aware that there might be someone really close to him at hell. This flash going to go over, and if he's peeking, he'll see it, but it looks like not. Ends up blinding Mr. Six. But no actions have been made yet. Now it looks like they're going to join him down ladder on the split, and Troni actually comes out on top. Biceps, however, a couple of really good kills, unanswered trades have resulted in the victory, it looks like, of Five Sports Club. One player left at Sonic over at E-Box, 20 HP. Swag would win this.
That would have been such a Fnatic-esque strategy from early train games where all of my solos go to T-Quad and he somehow managed to get a pick and then people just run out of ladder. Obviously, it doesn't work out that way. Mm-hmm. Even though he gets the first pick, then there's a player who's holding, I think it was MH Biceps, holding ladder.
I wonder if he's a Pasha fan or not. You'd have to assume, right?
You'd probably have to.
Yeah.
Good string of rounds here, though, for the Chinese side. They've definitely taken a hold of this game and fighting back into it.
It can be really easy to get terrified after losing that many CT rounds on train. Just start losing and losing and losing. But yeah, they really have gotten their feet on the ground. Inner player using his very valuable resources early on.
And it all started off of a force by where we even said, you know, this is, you know, they're feeling pressurized. They were 7-0 down. Mm-hmm. So they're 4-1 up since.
Yeah, absolutely good numbers to look at. No smoke for Backflop. We're going to run down this ramp and try to just trade him out. Die Saber, though, holding down that spray. Really good stuff. Now, if there's one thing we could say about a lot of the Chinese players, mechanically gifted for sure.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely.
Aim is on point.
Aim is on point. No better way to describe it. Last round of the half. Full buy up for Bravado. They really haven't put together just like a straight up full buy in quite some time. That was kind of key to their victories. On top of Black Poison opening up rounds for themselves over and over again.
I want to see them go back to the alley play, though.
I was just going to say.
Because it's really been working great, and we haven't really seen any massive adaptation from the Chinese side.
It was like 10 rounds of opening kills from Bravado, and then all of a sudden, Dreer getting these inner pushes and getting the opening kills for his team. And there it is, we got more of them. Die Saber also joining in to help him out. They have info. They know they've killed both ladder guys at the very least.
And I think they know there's two alley as well.
Ooh.
Wow, nice boost there, though.
Yeah, definitely.
It's going to open up the whole alley, and they're just going to be running out. As we can see, the CTs are playing really up close here on their own yard. And Black Poison with another headshot. And that's going to be advantage going the way of the South African team.
Absolutely some good stuff. And they still have potential for a split right now. Looks like they're holding back and Ivy just playing really carefully. Potentially waiting for a mistake. It's only a minute down, or a minute left over. That's quite a bit of time to be patient. Dice Saber is going to actually push through this or not. I mean, they were both turned around is the problem. Looking at that smoke would have been weird, right?
Yeah.
There's Mr. Six, the legend himself, to get both kills. No problem. 1v3 situation. And what I tell you, that's
the... Fair enough.
They talked about.
Fair enough.
By the book.
Wow. That was a great run. They got, what, 6 in a row?
Six in a row, yeah.
Yeah, so that ended up being from 7-0, from 0-7 to 7-8.
They say good half, but they don't mean it. That's 5 Sports Club finished with 7 rounds, but Bravado feel like they threw the rest of that half, right?
Yeah,
that's
basically.
You know, in the mentality there is just what did we do? We just blew.
They switched things up because they lost that round number 8, basically, mm-hmm. because they had everything going for themselves. They did that normal default strat. They got nullified on that one, mm-hmm. And then they started switching things up, and that's when 5 started to take initiatives. They started to take peaks, and they would win the initial duels. They would take Black Poison down a lot of the time, yeah. So it was being a massive part of Bravado getting those rounds. So, mm-hmm. you know, it's the small things that matter.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And it seems like just it's been a battle of this first kill over and over again. Just whoever's going to win. Is it going to be Black Poison, or is it going to be our boy, where is he? Not Dice Saber. It was Dreer, right? He's got 7 kills, but he definitely was the MVP of that half for them.
Yeah, for sure.
No doubt.
Having a rough start to it, though, apparently.
Definitely.
Well, it seems to be a prolonged halftime
here. This is one of the longest halftimes.
It's usually being pretty straightforward. Maybe they're thinking through their options. Do we buy a Deagle as well?
Do we buy a Deagle as well? I love the confidence in that Deagle. I would never buy a Deagle on a pistol run.
Yeah,
but partially because you don't get that dink sound. And for me, that's what it's all about.
For me, it's more about the fact that you can't really buy anything else except for the Deagle.
That's true, too. I love having armor. I hate getting aim punched.
Yeah, that's true. It is one of the least favorite things in this game.
Oh. If we're saving, I still sneak an armor buy in there. I'm the last to spawn and just half armor leave spawn. No one has to know.
We're ready here, by the way. Just saying, I think they think they're waiting for the stream.
No.
But we're ready here.
Oh, I forgot to push start. Sorry.
That's a beep, 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 beep.
Yeah.
There we go.
Caster, please start the game. That's what.
We have the power of everything. I mean, people were asking me to move games to the main stage.
Yeah.
I'm like, dude, I have that power.
Yeah, can you put, I think it was that start, the first star ladder, and someone was like, can you turn off the Russian casters in the main auditorium? I'm like, I'm in Ukraine. Sorry. yeah. Let's please.
There's limits to my power.
Yeah. Let's please the two English-speaking people in the crowd. You, the chat.
All right. I think we're gonna have the game start now. Oh, that's very quick. 10 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting to see what the Chinese side has to offer here in a T sign.
Yeah, really interesting to get to see the swap, and then also it's not like a really stompy one half, so it's not all about the pistol anymore.
Yeah.
We'll actually get to see like a fleshed out side from both of them.
Yeah.
They can't escape. They have to play these rifle rounds. We have to see how good they are.
Let's see. I think the Deagle Dream here is dying. It's dead. We have one set of nades.
Oh, there's still hope. Oh, okay.
I was talking about the teeth.
To buy a kit.
Right. Well, one set of nades for 5 Sports Club here. So that's going to be something rather simplistic coming up from them. And seemingly they're all heading towards the inner bomb site very, very fast here.
It's that lower ramp smoke. And ooh, Sonic, a really good way to get an opening kill. You can always beat them there. Get that long-range USP shot. You get all that info he spotted. So many people and the bomb can call for rotates. And it's really up to 5 Sports Club, to decide what they want to do here. Even the re-aggression, they haven't tested him. He's like, listen, I'm not leaving until you test me. Drop now into the site. 4 players have pushed on in. They finally kill him. 2-for-1. Not so bad. 4 players still left alive on the terrorist. A couple of USP shots being missed by Black Poison, but just as we call him out, he's able to get 3. Would you look at that? He's just warming
out
up.
Out of nowhere.
Yeah.
He was out of position in a very awkward position.
Very
all.
Awkward, yes.
Had like 6 bullets in his clip.
Half blind for a second.
And makes 3 kills out of it. Well, why not? Why not? Sonic, great stuff there with the initial peek, getting all that information. And that's a point in time where you get picked, you get spotted out, mm-hmm. and you're 4 and 5. You still have that set of nades to work with. I mean,
yeah.
Maybe you fall back, you just slow things down a little bit.
Guarantee the round, right?
You still have options, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, there could have been a different decision for sure. And all Bravado are going to be worried about now is this round coming up. They're five swords actually after getting that plant. I mean, this isn't all that uncommon to see. Is just instead of waiting for the AK armor low nades by.
Seems like they're going for the smoke setup here. Mm. Three guys see spawn basically setting up smokes and then just getting up close and personal with the Tech Nines is going to be the plan.
I expect to see. It's just a very standard split right now. Dreer has been spotted crossing Ivy, so they're always going to have to worry about him whether or not he ends up going here, which is the benefit to his positioning in this case. There it is, the flash is cascading over the site.
This alley guy needs to be patient, though.
Pouring out a T-Con, and yeah, he pulls the trigger a little bit early.
Way too early.
Yeah.
He needs to be alert.
Three blue guys getting kills. One bomb going down, which is a win in some sense, but they really were playing for the round win.
Exactly. When you're like that invested into it, and then definitely that's just going to be a consolidation prize, basically.
Yeah.
But yeah.
And I mean, every gun worth taking down in the situation, they did spend a lot on rifles.
None of the CTs even died.
No one died. Yeah. No casualties.
But yeah, the guy in alley, I think it was Dreer, definitely didn't have to be the guy to take an initiative. He needed to be the guy to come in later when there's some kind of a trade happening, so that maybe a distraction enough for the guy who's holding alley. And he's going to be looking at a different angle. Then he maybe times that guy, gets that kill, and being that final punch that's going to open the floodgates for the bomb site.
If this was matchmaking, I would love to have a teammate like that is just so hungry to come and help out the team that he's willing to pull the trigger early and a lurk. But in the match, yeah, man, go ahead, bait a little bit, and help your teammates after some kills happen. I'd say like my personal rule for lurking is if my teammates get a kill, I slow it down even more. My teammates start dying, I speed it up.
Yeah, it's a feeler position, right? I mean, you just kind of have to have a good feel for the game. We have a bit of a cleanup happening here. Well, not as clean as you could hope for, but still MH biceps alone here. Gets three and gets mowed down by Sonic in the end. That's going to be Bravado with another round. And enough money here for the Chinese side to buy fully AKs across the board. Mm-hmm. All needs as well. So now we get the first actual weapon round here in the second half.
This is definitely mano a mano. This is that was an economy building round for Bravado to build a safety net so that if they end up losing, it won't be that easy for Five Sports to earn themselves an eco. And one difference here is the op in the hands of Jatroni. We haven't seen that yet. I don't think they decided. Yeah, they didn't really op. T side of train, one of the hardest sides of any map to get op opening kills on.
As you can see, a difference here between these two teams from the get-go. Bravado always showing presence somewhere on the map, trade from the early seconds off the round, but the Chinese team not really doing anything in the first 40.
Oh, Black
Instead
Poison.
Of dying.
Man, this guy capitalizes, dude. That was sick.
Yeah, I mean, because I want to definitely, like, if you're going to play default, either you're going to show a presence in alley straight away, or you're going to take over the brown hall swords in a bomb site.
Mm-hmm.
Like completely, like show presence there. Make sure none of the C start pushing.
Push
if they
the wall,
are,
yeah.
Then you take that fight. Instead, they really didn't do either, and then ended up going towards inner bomb side very late, so that any CT could be any optimal positioning basically, and that's where Black Poison was, and he capitalized on the situation.
Only three up now for Five Sports. They don't have many options. Incredibly difficult to win at a disadvantage on T side here. And all of them getting picked apart. Yeah. No trades coming out. Barely any damage dealt. And simply no double peaks, no explosiveness whatsoever. Barely any nade usage. It looked like they played that run pretty scared, to be honest.
Yes, that was a classic what not to do example. Mm-hmm. Basically not doing anything. And everything they did was like in between things you should do, right? I mean, playing either super slow or fast and not something in between.
Mm-hmm.
Please do, like I just said earlier, show presence somewhere early on.
That was like when you start to lose faith in your teammates, you just go like tunnel vision, you stop calming so much and you just start doing individual things.
And like,
so everyone's trying to make
if you're going
to
go like late towards the inner bomb site, at least have a guy there together with you so you can at least try and trade a gun.
Right, at the very minimum. Because it's okay to lose a frag as long as it gets traded.
Yep. It's going to be an advantage for T-side in a 4-4,
yeah.
100%.
Well, they've made some space finally, inner. The bomb has not crossed yet. It's actually still upper. And we got one person on the site. He goes for a peek because he was probably going to... He just got mollied out anyway. He had to do something. But unfortunately, no bomb plan, as we mentioned. All players rotating from the inner site. So Z is being held pretty well, but actually Elusive was fully anticipating somebody to wrap that site. And now Virgili doesn't feel like he can get a plant here.
Oh, wow. That's a gap.
Yeah, I didn't even realize he could see.
Yeah.
Okay.
Fair enough.
Holy smokes.
Fair enough. Well, Bravado sitting on the driver's seat right now.
On their last limbs. I mean, Bravado
very
have,
firmly.
Are looking at like
yeah.
two.
They're swinging cash right now. They're like
picking up another op. This is going to be salt in the wounds, really.
Yeah, now this is the point in time where you kind of hope for five to do something fast because double ops.
Yeah, I'm kind of curious. I mean, smokes would work really well in this situation, so hopefully they don't just go into a default where they get strung out and just start dying individually. Maybe use these. Use this bit, use these resources, excuse me, to do something together. Something we haven't seen yet. They haven't even given themselves a shot to see whether that worked well on Bravado. Some teams are really bad versus execute, some teams are really bad versus fast stuff, and you've got to figure out what that is.
Yeah. Now, seems like they're going for a very heavy alley presence here. Five sports club. Three of them there. Wolfhounds coming out. Yep. Trying to apply some presence here.
The smoke isn't perfect, so Goals knows that he can kind of let his teammate know that he can watch it a bit. Some more resources coming out. They know there's multiple men coming up Ivy in this situation. Bomb on the backs of one of them. Hasn't been spotted, however. And this split is becoming very real right now for 5Sports. Very good that they pushed up this far. A lot of space created. Detroni's in a pretty awkward spot, but managed to get a kill and stay alive. Another one to complement it and almost falls back to an even better spot. Gold and his teammate now just in a 2-on-1. Have just MH biceps to deal with. He's been pretty good. Definitely. Oh, and they're both doing the top of the ladder thing. Let's see. This is really just a game of reads at this point.
Well, Sonic knows that he's low on HP, though. From that dink.
And you want to try to use as few footsteps as possible. Sound is your biggest and best friend in a 1v1 on the other side of train. But 10 seconds left. He's got to recover the bomb. And there's just so much incentive now. He does not need to take that fight whatsoever. His teammates probably, don't peek. Just stop.
He's just spray paint instead.
He's just spray paint instead. That's fine.
Because why not? Well, that was a alley push there, nullified by Bravado.
It wasn't bad though. The split, they actually got all the way up. Ivy.
I like the fact that they committed to it, like really 100%. Like they went for it once they were going. They didn't back off or anything. Like the only way you can really do it, right? But and then trades going back and forth. So a round where it was very winnable for them.
Yeah. Then Detroni just did a good job staying alive top of that train. They should have traded him, but. Yeah, overall, like the strategy was there. They committed. They had good spacing. Sometimes it doesn't work out that simply, though. Lower smoke is going to alert the Trani that he's not entirely safe at this moment. It's going to fall back to safer ground, back of the site. Really good angle. You can spot the head of somebody from the right side of this oil tanker. And Sonic with him up close in the lower ramp, not intending to get smoked out, and still has a smoke of his own.
And once again, advantage for Bravado, 5-on-4 situation. Still some grenades to work with here for 5Sports that seem to be gathering around here towards the inner bomb site, but still not decided on what they want to commit to. I think there's one in team mid right now, if I can see the minimap correctly. So might still opt to go for honor push here.
We haven't seen anything, any semblance of any type of fake. We've actually only seen one execute in general from 5Sports, so it's not on Bravado's radar, but it also doesn't seem like it's on the menu for 5Sports. They're just going to stick to what they know, and it's going to start with a walkout. Sonic, however, from Dennis is easily going to get a couple of kills. That AWP is still in play, and there are only two players remaining. Misses the flick, however, is put in a very bad spot, but as the bomb crosses, Detroni picks up another. Very good on the multi-frags with this AWP, and a third one to boot. 15 rounds now. The better of 5Sports.
Again, one by one. Like that seems to be a bit of an issue for 5Sports a lot of the time. That they end up being in situations where trades are not viable. They're not an option at all.
That happens, I feel like, because everybody gets focused on that one dude they see, whereas everybody's got to realize you have to create space and you have to worry about other people in the site. Like, just because you can't kill this one guy doesn't mean you have to just get tunnel vision.
Yeah, it's the big picture that matters. So you can see it's going to be a very quality buy here for 5Sports, and they've already made their way out of the team main, actually. But Black Poison with that AWP once again proving to be pretty strong.
Wow, almost 5 AWP kills, it feels like. And Mr. Six the legend goes down 2-0 as well. And who and Black Poison, was he the better player? Was Detroni the better player? We have a hero of the first half and a hero of the second half, don't we?
I'd have to say MVP has to be Black Poison, though. Like, he was such a key factor of the...
Doesn't look great.
Just fixing the second.